And it is the next video, second video of this lesson. Lesson number 12. Lesson heading, do you know the lesson heading? Sri Ramakrishna Paramhamsa. Now we are studying about the Ramakrishna Paramhamsa. Four paragraph completed. Now the fifth paragraph. Unlike most holy men, Sri Ramakrishna was not satisfied with knowing the truth of his own religion. He desired to have the same understanding of other religions, and for this he felt that he ought to live the disciplined life laid in every one of them. To understand Islam, he lived the life of a pious Muslim, and during this period he offered prayers of 5 times a day like a true Muslim. The unlike most holy men, we know number of holy men, spiritual leaders. In English, we can call them as spiritual leaders or religious leaders. Then compared to other holy men, or unlike the most holy men, Sri Ramakrishna was not satisfied with knowing the truth of his own religion. The most of the times, the religious leaders, they deeply studied their own religion. But in this case of Ramakrishna, he did not interested to study his own religion. He wanted to study other religions also. Other religions' principles, the habits, activities, functions, work, the belief of other religions also. So, Sri Ramakrishna was not satisfied with knowing the truth of his own religion. He decided to have the same understanding of other religions. He wanted to study the principles or values, beliefs of other religions. And for this, he felt that he ought to live the disciplined life laid in every one of them. Not to study the other religions' principle, he wanted to live a disciplined life. A disciplined life is necessary to study the other religions' principles. To understand Islam, first we will consider the Islam. Ramakrishna Ashil was a Hindu, but he wanted to study the Islam religion. He studied Islam. He lived life a pious. Pious means most purity. Pious Muslim. During this period, he offered prayers, 5 times prayers. We know the Muslims are doing the 5 time prayers. And Ramakrishna mission, Ramakrishna also doing that 5 time prayer. A day, like a true Muslim, they are offering 5 time prayers in a day. So in order to study the Islam religion, Ramakrishna became a true Muslim, to only just to study the religious principle. Okay, the next paragraph. Sri Ramakrishna then lived the disciplined life of a Christian, and at the end of that period had a vision of Christ. Then after studying the Islam religion, again he wanted to study the Christian religion also. Sri Ramakrishna then lived the disciplined life of a Christian, and at the end of that period had the vision of Christ. The first, he got the vision from the Divine Mother. The second, he studied about the Islam religion. Now he wanted to study the Christian religions, and during the period he got a vision from the Christ. He next studied the teaching of Buddha. Islam completed, Christians all completed. Now next is the Buddha. He wanted to again study the Buddha religions. He next studied the teaching of Buddha and Mahavir, Buddhism. Mahavir is the founder of that Jainism. Then Buddhism, Jainism, Islam, and Christian's religion. He studied the religious principles or religious values, moral principles of every religion. He also studied everything that a Sikh ought to know about his religion. Then Sikhism, his visions and his study proved to him that all religions teach the same truth and lead to the same goal. That is very important. You should underline that point. You must study the point. Keep the point in your mind. Write the point in your mind. All religions, he understand one truth. All religion lead to the same goal. And he taught the world that it is not wise to quarrel over names. He studied all the religions. How many religions? First Hinduism, Islam, then Christianity, Buddha, Jainism, and Sikhism. He studied five religions. Deeply studied, detailed study. Then after the studies of five religious principles, he made a conclusion that the goal of every religion are same. His visions and his study proved to him to that all religions teach the same truth and lead to the same goal. And he taught the world that it is not wise to quarrel over names. Sri Ramakrishna also told the world that everyone should live a poor life without caring for wealth, power or fame. He talked about a lotus as an example of such a life. A lotus does not go to the bees, but the bees flock round it because it has honey to give. In the same way, if he lived a poor life and have some things to give to the world, people will flock around us. Sri Ramakrishna himself lived such a life, and so he attracted a large number of disciplines. Disciplines means followers or students. And this paragraph gives us another explanation or meaning. The main important point is that here we saw an example of lotus. Lotus is lying in the water. The bees are coming there. For what purpose? To take the honey. Why? Because the lotus has the honey. The honey is a delicious or sweet item. It's a good character. The good deeds. Something positive. Some good values. That's why the bees are attracted by the honey or by the lotus. That's why Ramakrishna, he got a number of followers in the world. One day, young man came to see him. His name was Narendra. He was studying in a university and he decided to know the truth about God. One day, a young man came there. His name is Narendra. Don't forget the name. The name is very historically great important name, Narendra. He was studying in a university and he decided to know the truth about God. Narendra wanted to study about the God. He wanted to know about the truth of God. His university did not help him this, but the university and in the university the subject they are teaching, the subject English, science, social science, these are the subjects, Sanskrit. And the university does not teach any religious principles or values. So he asked all the saints and holy men, he meant, do you believe in God and have you seen him? But everyone of them said, I believe in God, but I have not seen him. Narendra asked the saints, Narada asked so many religious people or spiritual leaders, do you believe in God and did you see the God? Most of the people, most of the saints replied that they believe in God. That's one point. But they do not see God. They did not satisfy. Sorry, this does not satisfy Narendra. So he went to Sri Ramakrishna and asked, do you believe in God? Yes. But how do you know that God exists? Then how you see him? I see God just as I see you. I see God just as I see you. This was the answer Narendra had been looking for. At last, he said to himself, here is a man who has seen the God. Last, Narendra made a conclusion. At last, finally, here is a man who has seen the God. And as he stood here, Sri Ramakrishna touched him and he began to feel as if the whole world was spinning around him. Soon after, he became a disciple of Sri Ramakrishna. The young Narendra later became the famous Swami Vivekananda. Do you know the name of that Narendra? He became the famous Swami Vivekananda, who carried Sri Ramakrishna message to all parts of the world. Actually, then Swami Vivekananda became a good follower or good disciple of Sri Ramakrishna. So Sri Swami Vivekananda's guru, great teacher, was Sri Ramakrishna. Don't forget it. The young Narendra later became the famous Swami Vivekananda, who carried Sri Ramakrishna's message to all parts of the he spread the message. Swami Vivekananda, he spread the message. Whose message? Sri Ramakrishna's message to all parts of the world. Okay. This is enough for the second video. The next video, the last part of this video, then we will meet again in the next video.